Village Church on this lovely day. Now, we've been talking for the last few weeks about families and all the different people you can get within a family. And so I thought, well, I'll bring a special family along for you this morning. Now, as you know, a family usually consists of some adults, big people, stand up, big person, there we go, maybe you can lay down, and a family of big people, usually some kids, here we go, there's some kids, and there we have sometimes a family. Now, occasionally, we have somebody different that comes into the family, and they may be very different from us, but we can still love and care for them exactly as if they were our brothers, our sisters, our mum or dad, uncles and aunties, or anybody else in our family. And so we may just have somebody who is totally different, who comes into our family. Now, as I was thinking about this, I wondered if there were any stories in the Bible where there's somebody different that comes into a special family. And I looked all the way through, and guess what? I came up with a really special one, and it's one of my favourite stories too. Mainly because the people involved have some interesting names. It concerns a king, it concerns a little boy, and, well, I'm not going to say any more. I'll just get on with the story and show you what it's all about. So I'll take this family away. Come along, people, off you get. There we go. And we'll clear the way, and here we go. This story is about a king called David. And here's King David. King David was very, very sad. King David had grown up in the household of King Saul. And he'd made a very special friend of King Saul's son called Jonathan. One day, King Saul and Jonathan were killed in a big battle, and David was very, very sad. He loved his friend Jonathan very, very much. Now, David was now king, and David wanted to know if there was anybody left in the whole of the kingdom who was related to his friend Jonathan, because he thought of Jonathan as being his very special brother. They looked after each other, they fought together, they'd saved each other's lives, they'd laughed together, and now Jonathan was gone. And so David was very sad. Well, David sent around the country to see if there was anybody left who was a friend or a relation of Jonathan, his best friend. Finally, he found a man who'd been a servant to King Saul. And the servant came to King David and he said, "There is someone still alive, King David. His name is," and here comes the big name, are you ready for it? "Mephibosheth." And Mephibosheth is about 5 years old. And David said, "Wow, that's fantastic. How did he survive?" "Well," said the servant, "when the soldiers came to kill David, to kill Jonathan and King Saul, the nurse who was looking after Mephibosheth picked him up and ran away as fast as she could to a safe place. But on the way, she fell over. And poor little Mephibosheth fell over too. and he hurt his legs. And now he can't walk properly anymore. Now he's living in a safe house, David. Would you like me to find him for you? Yes, of course, said King David. I would love you to find him for me. And so the servant went, and he brought the little boy, Mephibosheth, to David's house. King David was very, very pleased, and now he was happy. He wanted to treat Mephibosheth just like a member of his own family. Although Mephibosheth was very different and wasn't related to him at all, he took him in, he was kind to him, he showed him all the things and did all the things for him that he would have done for his very own son, because Mephibosheth was the son of his very special friend, Jonathan. So David showed him kindness. And I think that story shows us very much how we should show kindness to people who are different to us, who come into the circle of our family. Thank you for listening. And now John's going to show you how to make your own special Mephibosheth puppets.
Hello there. For making the puppets, we need a number of things. I've got here some felt of different colours, but you can use coloured paper or coloured cardboard. I have some already cut out little men. But if you don't have those, I'm going to show you how you can cut out your own little men. We need ordinary sandwich bags, and if you haven't got the, and of course texters, and if you haven't got the little men, you need a piece of cardboard or plain paper. Now what we do first is we fold it in half that way. And then we fold it in half again. So it looks like that. Then one of these we fold back. And press press that down. And then the other side, we fold back the other way. And press that down.
Hold it up.
And then it will look like that if you pull it out slightly. Now, we get a pencil or a texter. And on the side that is folded, so this side, we're going to draw half of a little man. So he has a nice round head that goes part of the way round, and then an arm goes straight to the edge like that. And then the second half of the arm comes down to his body. And the body comes down a bit and then to the leg. And the leg goes right to the edge. And then further down we have another leg. The half of the leg comes up and that goes across to there. So it looks just like that. And now we cut around the outside for all of those pieces. So we can cut just around what we've drawn. And then it looks like that. And as we open it up, you'll find we have two men. What we're going to do is to make on one, we make a sad King David, because he's sad because he's still thinking of his friend Jonathan, and a happy King David on the other side of that one. And on the second bag we have Mephibosheth, who's got a very strange name, but he can't help that, can he? Some of us have names other people think are strange, like my name's John. Some people think that's strange. We get some glue, which of course I managed to forget to bring, and we put glue over all over that, and we stick it down. And remember, the puppet goes that way up, so your hand goes into it. So the man, the head must be near where the bag is closed, like that. So we stick that down. We can draw a face, and of course with a sad King David, his mouth goes down. But with a happy King David, his mouth goes up at the sides, like that. And we keep drawing features, so he has eyes and hair. And then when we finish doing his face and perhaps his hands and his feet, we get a piece of felt or card or paper, and we cut out a piece to make his cloak. And he usually wears a long coat rather than trousers and a jumper like we would. And you cut that out nicely, and you can glue that over him. I'm using purple because he's a king, and the kings in the days of King David used to wear purple because it was a very expensive and special colour. And so we can cut out a piece the right size, and of course he has to have a neckline so he can get his head through there. and it goes in slightly at the sides because he's got a bit of shape in him, unlike me. So it looks a bit like that, and then we stick that onto there so that it looks a bit like that. And then, of course, what else does a king need? A king needs a crown, and most kings like to wear crowns of special colours, and so we're going to make a golden crown. Now, we need two of all of these things, one for a happy King David and one for a sad King David. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut a piece of felt like that. That's about the right size for a crown. So that's about the right thickness or width for a crown. And then rather than cut two crowns separately, I'm going to cut two crowns out of this one piece. And crowns have ups and downs bits. A bit like that. So they come out like that, but if we turn that one over, we have two crowns. And then we stick one crown onto King Saul's head on one side, and one crown onto King's head on the other side. And then we do the same for Mephibosheth, and we end up with two puppets that we can tell the story with.